Well, good afternoon everybody, and welcome to Mark's allotment number 10, I believe. 9 or 10, I can't remember now, but anyway. The last one was showing you planting up my greenhouse, but I thought I'd come down and bring you up to speed on the actual allotment. So I'll just turn the camera around now and hopefully you'll be able to hear me a bit better as well. So. Okay, so obviously now it's been very hot for the last couple of weeks, desperate for water, but lettuce, some nice lettuce coming up, and some onions and garlic. My beans, broad beans, these are the ones I planted in November. Rhubarb is looking a bit sick, but no, they'll be all right. And of course the jackdaws are enjoying my beans as well. They seem to have left them alone for the last couple of days, but anyway. And obviously the other ones that they planted, they start to catch up now, and they'll start producing pods very soon. The potatoes are starting to come now. These are my secondaries. They're much further ahead than the main crop. But as I say, we desperately need some water now, and. So, as we're not on the mains here, some more onions and lettuce come up nicely. My peas coming through now. I have to remove this at some point. Not quite sure if this experiment with the onions and the ridge is going to work, but you know, we'll give it a go and see what happens. It's a case of watch this space. This is perpetual beet coming up. It's very similar to spinach. You use it like spinach, but the good thing about this is that you cut it and it comes again. So you don't have to worry about that. Downside of it, the downside of perpetual beet is if you let it grow to maturity and until it forms seed heads, etc., which, you know, obviously you can collect the seed. But the roots are very deep and very big, so be aware of that if you grow in that sort of stuff. The fennel is coming again that I cut back. Very nice. Obviously we save the seeds off this, which we then use for fish dishes, etc. If you don't know what fennel is, tastes like or smells like, it's like aniseed basically. So that's fennel. But this is the fennel type that, I think it's called Florence fennel. I'd have to check on that. But anyway, it's the tops. Whereas the other variety, which is the root type or the globe type, my Swedes, they're coming well now. These are going to have to be thinned out at some point. Now I had some leftover Borlotti beans, Borlotti, I believe they spelled, Borlotti beans. Had some leftover in the plastic container and I didn't think they were going to come because quite a few of them had gone mildew. But, as you can see, they are coming now. When they're a little bit, next couple of days when I get a bit of time, I'll transplant these across to my other poles over there. Now, probably in this row here you can't really see it that clearly, but they are coming up. I'll try, right, there we are. I'll just point to there and I'll bring it in slowly. That's fennel as well, but that's the globe type, and that's, you eat the actual flesh of the root, I suppose. Very nice in salads and stir fries, etc. It's absolutely boiling today. Now then, here, on up to there, I think I've overdone it a bit, but these are all I forgot the name now. Right, not Maras. Oh, I can't remember. Anyway, the I've got two types here, yellow and the green type of, heck, why can't I think of the name? Anyway, courgette, of course it is. Cricky, I'm going mad. But if all these come, I'll be absolutely inundated with courgettes. I may end up pulling some of the plants out, I don't know, but right, moving on. Now, I remember, if you remember me telling you about this patch here where the compost bin used to be, I've now planted four cauliflower plants in there. They are coming, but very slowly. It's because the lack of rain, nothing is, it's just about moving. Amount of hand water, everything. I've also planted in two rows of summer cabbages. Not sure the variety, but when I actually bought these, they didn't grow them myself. These are a cone shape cabbage, summer cabbage. And then we've got sweet corn, obviously. Grow this in a block. Now you may have noticed all my cabbage plants, well, brassicas, I always put a a collar of some sort around them. In this instance, I've used, these are I used to work supporting adults with disabilities, and one of the guys I used to help support, he had to be fed. He couldn't be fed through his mouth. He had to be fed through his directly into his stomach, unfortunately. Anyway, the feed that he used to get comes in these plastic bottles. Then I just cut the top off and use those. But obviously, you can use old slug pellet containers or, you know, tin cans even. But the only problem with tin cans, of course, is they go rusty eventually. Right. Remember me telling you about the parsnip, single parsnip. This is going to seed now, as you can see, and I don't know how many seed heads there are here, but there's loads of them. You know, they're all over the shop. Put a stake in to help support it. I haven't done it yet, but I will put a bit of string or something around it just to tie it in and brace it to that support. Now I will literally get thousands of seeds off this. You know, so it's worth putting one to letting one go to seed for your own use. Excuse me. Right, I've also got some climbing French green beans down here, and my wife prefers these to the runner beans. These are runner beans, which I've put in to fill any gaps, which I haven't got, but I will use them up. I'll add them to the others over there. So I shall show you now. And as I say, my bolotti beans are going to go in this space here when they're big enough. Because if what I tend to like doing is with the bolotti beans, I like them to go to seed. And then I collect the seeds, and then them in stews. They're lovely in stews. These a few runner beans. So we eat runner beans. I know we said my wife prefers the green beans, but that's only for freezing. But the runner beans, we don't, for some reason, they're not very nice when we freeze them, or at least I don't particularly like them. So we don't bother. We just have enough to eat fresh, and then that's it. Keep a few seeds back for next year. That's about it. Odd one over there. But I say, these ones here, what I'll do is I'll double them up on each of the canes. So I'll have two plants per cane. And that'll be more than enough for what my needs. Another couple of collies in the position where the compost bin used to be. Now, if you remember, if you saw the last actual allotment video, I acquired two tyres off a Porsche. There they are. And the idea, I filled this one up with compost. The idea is then to, I'll put some late carrots in here, ready for the winter. Another one, that'll be the same, so I've just got to buy another bag for that. I've just put sticks on to stop the cats getting into it. As you can see, it's absolutely... I've used up virtually all my water at the moment. Now then, parsnips that I put in for insurance purposes, there they are. But not all of these have come, unfortunately. So I've got one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. I think it's eight altogether, yeah. So, I'll keep eight parsnips will keep me going for a while. So that's the, as I say, that's the top lot, and now moving to the bottom one. Now I've got all along here and there, that's purple sprouting and Brussels sprouts. As I said, I dug a trench and allowed, and as I watered and as they grew, the soil works its way, works its way back in slowly as the plants grow, and then it makes them a bit more stronger in the ground. The ryegrass, I found a few odd clumps and I've transplanted them, and they seem to be doing okay now. They've gone to seed, so that'll provide me with, not enough, but it'll provide me with some seed to plant my ryegrass for next year to dig in. Raspberries are starting to form now. Now then, if you remember, I said to you about parsnips in this. Now these are doing really well, and looks like this is going to be the method I'm going to use from now on. Excuse me, but the only thing that I didn't anticipate, I put the compost in and I filled it to the brim, but of course, because it's such a loose material, I forgot that it was going to settle down, and it settled down about 2 inches or more. So as a result, that's going to make the roots a bit shorter. I mean, it'll be enough for my use this year, but next year what I will do is I'll add the second collar, and I'll have 2 collars depth, and that'll give me lovely deep roots then, or long roots. Well, there's a few leeks that I put in, but they're not coming to anything, so I'm not going to worry about them anymore. I've got some more at home. Some odd shallots that I found and put in, thought I might as well use them up. Now, there's some carrot seeds in here. This is the fourth attempt at sowing them. I don't know what's going on, but they don't seem to be germinating, and I've bought new seed and all sorts. So it's just too hot, I think. Currant bushes are coming. No, I think these, I can't remember, I don't think this is a, I think this is the black currant, but this is the red currant. As you can see, they're starting to go red. So, obviously, as soon as they go red, the birds will be in here like a shot, so I'm going to have to put some net over that, netting over it. On the side, I haven't filmed these before. I can see them quite easily, but off the camera you can't really see them, but the gooseberries are starting to come. Perhaps I can show it in contrast to the red handle. So they're coming nicely. Red currants over there as well, they're coming nicely. And of course my strawberries. I say my strawberries, they're not my. In fact, you wouldn't believe, but all these were virtually yellow last night. So they came down, and look how overnight these are all almost turned red. That's how hot the sun is. So I'm gonna have to pick those before the slugs or the birds get at them. Now then, I've got an odd two purple sprouting broccoli plants here, which I'll leave. I'll let them develop naturally now. I won't cut them down or anything. Might as well make use of them. Because I seem to remember I had a plant here once, and they must, obviously the seed has dropped and it's reseeded itself. So the nature seems to be doing a better job than me. Now, what's going on here? Now, look at this. Now, I don't know why they have come off. I'm wondering if birds are having a go to... yeah, that's doing really well as far as red currants are concerned. Yeah, I don't know. Perhaps the birds are having a go testing them out. So, I'll be alright for red currants this year. My potatoes in tyres, as you can see now, is starting to come now. It's actually flowering. Yeah, I was going to add a little bit more compost, but I think I'll just leave this now to mature, and then obviously I'll feed it and water it as time goes on. So we'll see how that develops. Pumpkin plants, three of them. Yeah, in fact there's some flower heads starting to come now, so I'm hoping I can do well out of these this year. What else have we got going on? Right, these are cabbages, these are autumn. Hang on, I'll soon tell you. I've written it down, oh yeah, January Kings. So these are January Kings. They'll be obviously ready. Well, they're ready when they're ready, of course, but usually in the winter months. And then, what have I got here? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 20. 20 cauliflower plants. These are collies as well, but they're a different variety. So, they'll be... I'll get a crop out of them. And the reason these are doing so well here is because this patch all around here, it's very soggy. Even now, after 2 weeks of no rain, it's still quite wet underneath. And quite frankly, I don't know where the water's coming from. My comfrey is ready for another cut. And my nettles. So they're coming along nice. No, I don't know if you can see, but grass is going brown now. But that's not because of lack of water. It's because I sprayed everywhere with weed killer because I was struggling to fit everything in, so I didn't have time to hoe and all the rest of it. So I basically used the weed killer, glyphosate weed killer, to kill all, you know, help keep the weeds down for myself. Now then, so that's basically up to date at the moment. The well, I had a look last night and the well has still got water in it, believe it or not. I think this slope is about, I think, about 30-40 degrees slope. Anyway, the well, if you can see, so that is that level has stayed like that for days and days. So what I want to do is empty it out and see if it refills, and that'll tell me then if there's water percolating down into it from somewhere else, which on a really hot weather like this is great, because what I would like to do is to put a solar powered pump into that container and then pump it, well, I don't know where yet, but I mean I'd like to put it into a header tank up there, but I think the amount of lift required would be more, would be too much for a solar powered pump, but I'll have to research that. I'll need to check that out. So that's us up to date. Now, let's see, what's the date today? It's the 8th today. No, sorry, it's the 9th today. Anyway, and, oh, right, I just spotted something. Now, this is horseradish. Now, really, you wouldn't normally put horseradish in open ground unless, because it does spread like mad, apparently. But I've put it there simply because the container it was growing in, I had to get rid of the container, so I've put them in there for this year, but I'll dig them out and put them in another container to contain it. But that is yesterday. There was hardly any leaf there, but in one overnight and in one day, it's grown that much. It's unbelievable. And so that's about it. Bye for now.